Vessel in distress, this is Coast Guard Lake Worth. What is your position, over?
I'm gonna need a, I'm on set down for the surveillance. A vessel just ran my diver over. Coast Guard Lake Worth, Coast Guard, come in.
Go ahead, sir.
I'm proceeding to surveillance. I'm gonna need an ambulance. I got a man with his leg cut off.
Okay, are you heading into the inlet now or what?
I'm headed for Surrey Inlet.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Dave Bingham with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. Snorkeling and scuba diving are a popular sport here in Florida. While participating in that type of activity, snorkelers and scuba divers are required to fly a diver's down flag. Today I'm going to discuss the rules and regulations associated with divers and their diver's down flags. The first thing that you must know is what is a diver's down flag and what are the required sizes for dive flags on vessels or dive flags being pulled by a diver. A diver's down flag must be red in color with a white diagonal stripe that begins at the top staff side of the flag and extends diagonally to the lower opposite corner. If you choose to display a flag on your vessel, your flag is required to be 20 by 24 inches. The flag is supposed to be positioned at the highest point of your vessel so it's visible and free from obstruction. Your flag must also have a stiffener as required by law. If you choose to pull a flag around you while you are diving, your flag is required to be 12 by 12. Divers shall not display a diver's down flag on rivers, inlet, or navigational channel if it constitutes a navigational hazard. All divers shall stay within 100 feet of a diver's down flag on rivers, inlets, and navigation channels. Any person operating a vessel on a river, inlet, or navigational channel must maintain a distance of at least 100 feet from any diver's down flag. Divers must stay within 300 feet of a diver's down flag on the ocean or waters other than rivers, inlets, or navigation channels. Remember, if you're planning to dive along the reef line, it's a great idea to carry a pull flag with you since other vessels may want to dive in those types of areas. We find that most scuba divers tend to swim farther than 300 feet. Boat operators should constantly scan the area to determine if divers are in the water. So let's say you see a diver's down flag. What should you do? The first thing is to determine your distance from the flag. If you feel like you are within 300 feet, immediately slow your vessel and veer away. If you are approaching a 300 foot, steer away and give a diver some room. Any vessel that approaches within 100 feet of a diver's down flag on a river, inlet, or navigation channel, or within 300 feet of a diver's down flag on the ocean or waters other than a river, inlet, or navigation channel, must proceed at idle speed. The diver's down flag must be lowered once all divers are out of the water. The FWC now has a way to enforce the diver's down flag law utilizing laser radar. We can now determine the distance that divers stray from their flag and also determine the distance boats come within a flag. The radar is so accurate, it's within plus or minus 1 inch. Here are some common mistakes made by people when displaying their diver's down flags. Failing to display at the highest point of their vessel, or using the smaller flag on their vessel, or failing to have a stiffener in the flag, or mounting their flags upside down. If you're injured by a vessel while diving and you failed to properly display your diver's down flag, you could be held at fault. Think about it. For many divers, they'll never be able to experience what Lisa Rollins did one day while diving with her friends Rob and Barry. It's a tragic reminder of what can happen on the water.
We were surfacing from our dive and I was in about 15 feet of water, and Rob and Barry broke the surface, and within seconds the boat was on top of us, and I watched the entire thing from 15 feet below the water and saw the boat hit him and raced to the surface, and it was blood and screaming, and it was the most horrifying thing I'd ever been involved in, not to mention just seeing another person going through that, but knowing it was my friend. It really, in all practicality, there's no reason he should be alive. He should have bled to death in that boat. If more people know that when you don't respect the dive flag, you can kill somebody, you can ruin their life, you can change it in ways that you just can't ever imagine. The first few weeks he was in the hospital, after he said thank you, thank you, thank you, he acknowledged that his legs don't make him who he is. He is who he is without his legs, but I still wish he had them. I'll always have him in my heart, and I know that, you know, no matter where he is, that day, I'll just never forget it.
Diving accidents like Rob's are real and have lifelong consequences, so do your part and be a safe boater. Understanding the rules and regulations associated with diving is a matter of life or death.